देवाय तस्मै नमः। We were reading 16th chapter, Devasura Sambat Vibhaga Yoga. Sambat is quality. So there are two different varieties of qualities. One is Deva quality and another one is Asura quality. So we have seen in the first three verses 28 varieties of descriptions, 26 or there are different people numbering it different. It could be 16 or 20, 28, because some of the qualities are related. But major numbers are 9 qualities in the first verses. Second verse we have 10 to 14, I think, and 15. No, up to 20 qualities in the second verse. Third verses we have 21 to 26.
So is fearlessness the very first thing that he has mentioned? Yeah. I wonder why.
Yeah, that is because the whole Bhagavad Gita talks about Ma Shucha. The ending of Bhagavad Gita in the 18th chapter is Ma Shucha, don't be sad. Generally, sadness is a fear. And the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita in the 12th chapter, Krishna starts with Ashochya and Anyashochyastham. People should, a person who is worried or who is in tension, who is scared of things, a fearfulness is what gives you dukkham. The reason for Arjuna to be in dukkham is fear. That is what generally, right? A Veera Purusha doesn't have fear. So that is where the whole Bhagavad Gita, if you want to say what is the message Bhagavad Gita is giving, Ma Shucha. So if you are strong, if you are courageous, you will never feel sad about anything. You are not fearful. That is why some of the qualities, if you look at it, you will see it is repeated in a different style. But essence is be bold. Right? And the fourth verse, three verses for Devika Guna and one verse for Asura Guna.
He does this also in different places, right? In the second chapter, he talks about the qualities and virtues.
Yeah.
He does the same thing.
Yeah. This 16th chapter may be somewhere we can refer to many of the Upanishads. Last time I was telling, we can read Katha Upanishad here, we can read Mundaka Upanishad here, almost all Upanishads. And in Ramana Maharshi's Upadesha Saram, we can see, and every content is seen in this chapter. The whole Bhagavad Gita, that's why I said Ma Shucha, the starting, end Ma Shucha, and the beginning second chapter. A consolidated version is, because this is Dharma Shastra. 15, 16, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 are real Sankhya, but in which Dharma Shastram is coming in 15 and 16. So it's to make people stronger. The whole Bhagavad Gita is to make people strong, bold enough to face any situation. Now he will start comparing both Devikam and Asurikam, mixed. So we have done up to fourth verses. Only four verses we did last time. Now we will go to the fifth one. Devi Sambat.
Devi Sambat.
Vimokshaya.
Vimokshaya.
Nibandhaya.
Nibandhaya.
Asuri Mata.
Asuri Mata.
Ma Shucha.
Ma Shucha.
Sambadam Devim.
Sambadam Devim.
అభిజాతోసి పాండవ దేవీ సంపత్, ద దైవ సంపత్, ద డివైన్ క్వాలిటీ. దేవి ఈజ్ డివైన్, సంపత్ ఈజ్ క్వాలిటీ, డివైన్ క్వాలిటీ. వి మోక్షాయ, ఇట్ గివ్స్ యూ మోక్ష, లీడ్స్ యూ టు మోక్ష. సో దట్ ఈజ్ వాట్ లీడ్స్ యూ టు మోక్ష. బెస్ట్ మెథడ్ టు గెట్ మోక్ష ఈజ్ గెట్ ఇన్ టు ద డివైన్ క్వాలిటీస్. నిబంధాయ ఆసురి మత, నిబంధం, బంధం ఈజ్ బాండేజ్, నిబంధం బీయింగ్ బాండేజ్. సో బీయింగ్ ఇన్ బాండేజ్ ఈజ్ ఆసురి. మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ ఫియర్ ఈజ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ బాండేజ్. యు హ్ నో బాండేజ్, నో ఫియర్. వి ఆర్ కనెక్టెడ్ టు సంబడి. ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ లాస్ట్ టైం, మై డాటర్ వెంట్ సమ్వర్, మై సన్ వెంట్ సమ్వర్, ఐఎమ్ వరీడ్. మా శుచ, ద శుచ ఈజ్ బికాస్ ఐ హ్యావ్ గాట్ బాండేజ్. దెర్ ఈజ్ నో బాండేజ్, వై డూ యూ వరీ? హియర్ ఆర్ దర్ డజంట్ మ్యాటర్. నిబంధాయ ఆసురి మత. సో వాట్ ఈజ్ గివింగ్ యూ ద ఆసురి క్వాలిటీ ఈజ్, అసురా క్వాలిటీ ఇస్ బాండేజ్. సో దోస్ హూ ఆర్ థింకింగ్ మోర్ అబౌట్ రిలేటివ్స్, ఫ్రెండ్స్, దర్ వరీస్ అండ్ ఆల్ దట్, దే ఆర్ ఆల్ అసురాస్. దేవాస్ ఆర్ నాట్ వరీడ్ బికాస్ యు ఆర్ ఆల్రెడీ కనెక్టెడ్ టు దేవా. యూ లీవ్ ఇట్ టు దెమ్. వీ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ఫెయిత్, రైట్? మా శుచ సంపదం దేవి, మా శుచ, డోంట్ బీ సాడ్, డోంట్ గ్రీవ్, డోంట్ బీ అన్హ్యాపీ, డోంట్ కీప్ క్రయింగ్. ఆల్ ద నెగటివ్ క్వాలిటీస్ ఈజ్ ఎండింగ్ విత్ శుచం. మా శుచ సంపదం దేవీం, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ దేవ క్వాలిటీ. అభిజాదోసి పాండవ, యు ఆర్ అభిజాతన్, యు ఆర్ టేకన్ బర్త్ ఇన్ విచ్ ఎవర్ క్వాలిటీ యు ఆర్, ఐదర్ ఇన్ అసుర ఆర్ దేవ. దిస్ ఈస్ హౌ ద పార్టీషన్ ఈస్ పాండవ. దేవీ సంపత్ విమోక్షాయ నిబంధాయ ఆసురీమత, మా శుచ సంబదం దేవీం, అభిజాతోసి పాండవ. సో ద సెకండ్ చాప్టర్ 11th ఈస్ స్టార్టింగ్ విత్ అశోచ్యాన్య శోచ్యస్తం. ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ భగవద్గీత ఈస్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ 16th వర్స్. సర్వధర్మాన్ పరిత్యజ్య మామేకం శరణం వ్రజ, అహం త్వా సర్వ పాపేభ్యో మోక్ష ఇష్యామి మా శుచ. The war could be between your buddhi to manas, or all the worries in this world is between buddhi to manas only. If you go into the details, you will understand there is only one worry for any human being, that is between buddhi and manas. You think whether it is logical or emotional, correct? To do or not to do, the biggest question in the world, to do or not to do, right? The vacillation, that's the problem, is that only. So asura and devikam, that is what is being explained here. Mahashucha, do not worry, that's the essence, which is the essence of Bhagavad Gita, which is in the 16th chapter, 5th sloka. Now 6th one. Dhau Buddha Sargau లోకేస్మిన్ దేవ ఆసుర ఏవ చ, దేవో విస్తరశః ప్రోక్తః అసురం పార్థమే శృణు. దౌ భూత స్వర్గౌ, భూతం మీన్స్ ఎనీ క్రియేషన్ ఇన్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ భూతం. శ్రీభూత బలి, any living being for which the Buddha is done is called Buddha Bali. Whatever we throw to the as a food which is throwing out is also not waste because it is eaten by somebody else. So we call it as Buddha Bali.
So he is saying that either you are Asura or Deva.
Deva.
You are born with it based on your sanskar from
previous janma.
Previous janma.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Wherein you can have
which is less. Depends on which is more, which is less.
Yeah, this is our basic character. But your swabhavam, swabhavam is that. Swabhavam is that. But at each point of time, you can bring in your other three gunas which was explained in the earlier chapter. Sattvic, Rajasic, Tamasic. Mix them for a good purpose. Many people mistake that Asura means they are Rajasic. No. In Sattvic also you can have a Rajasic quality. You are pushing something to happen for a good purpose. When you keep doing it in a good satsang, you will turn your quality to be. So he is going to tell that you take many births in the Asura and you refine yourself to get a Deviga quality next time.
Dr. TPS, so does that mean ends justifies the means?
The action also justifies, because you can do harm to many for a small good purpose. So the end in my concept is not good enough. For a general public, you have to be good. Duryodhana was good. Probably Duryodhana was good for few people. That is why Shakuni is with him, Karna is with him. They had options. So few people are happy with him. But that's not good enough. By bondage, some people are with him, though they are unhappy. Like Bhishma was totally unhappy because of a bondage, he was there supporting him.
But sir, I think everyone is born with Devika and Asurika.
Asurika in a combination.
So I don't know why Lord Krishna says we have two, like it's a binary thing. It's not binary, is it? It's a mix.
All the three qualities, when we say one third, one third, one third, right? Here also it is half, half. But it will not come out at all because it has been hidden inside you for many generations. But for some people, only that quality will come, though the chances are given for them to develop. Right? So in that, one of the qualities, Bhagavad Gita itself and the purpose of Bhagavad Gita reading, they will tell you, listen to this 100 times. That will wash away your Asurika quality. Because listening that itself is a great thing. You are giving ear to a God version, right? Some words from God is good enough to clean up something. But then they will say that start reading by yourself. Do sadhyaya. Then start teaching. These are all method to... There are different methods. One, bhakti is one of the mechanism. Second one is be with satsang. Do good archana and such qualities. But they are all only one part of it. The major part is how to serve the humanity. That's why in the Dharma Shastra also, Sanatana Dharma, two qualities. One is for self to clean up. That is Ishta Karma. That is less of importance when you compare with the Purta Karma. Purta Karma is what is good for somebody else. Maybe a small bad thing in your life can be compensated. The punishment given is to, plant a lot of trees, clean a lake, make a path.
So back to Anand's point, this idea of Devas and Asuras, or Pandavas and Kauravas, is the idea of what he brings as Devika and Asurika qualities.
Here, do we say Duryodhana by birth was Asura? Then their parents would have been Asuras?
Actually, wasn't Duryodhana and his 99 brothers, weren't they by birth because of what happened to Gandhari's womb, right?
Yeah.
Could that
so why Gandhari had that fate because of her previous janma, right? But there was an option for him to clean up. That did not happen because he had good guru. He had the association of Lord Krishna. Seeing Lord Krishna personally is a great thing than reading Bhagavad Gita, right? Even with that, he couldn't improve. So that's why I said options are given. You are taken close to the path, but still people don't change. Why it doesn't happen? That is because of one is satsang. The most important part which creates these qualities are satsang.
So that also goes back to Duryodhana's birth. When Duryodhana was born, weren't the sages and everyone saying, please get rid of this child,
yes,
because
yes,
he is going to... So he was an asura by...
Yeah. So the time of birth, the place of birth, the reason for that, all that becomes the mood in which the mother conceived and the food what the mother took on that day. All that can have an impact on the child. Right? That is why giving birth was a great saintly process in earlier tradition. That's why in, I think one of the sessions we told in the Sunday sermon. It is by accident most of the parents become parent because by accident. Right? It is not of choice. So the food itself matters a lot. The environment in which, with whom they are associating, the food what you eat, with what sort of people you are into, all that will change.
In one earlier, we have said that those who are on this path to self-realization, they will be born in a more conducive environment that they can continue the pursuit.
Yeah. And even if you don't reach at the end, you may discontinue. In the next janma, you have a chance to continue. But sometime you get into a worse situation, then you will lose all the path also. So one janma to next janma, you can continue sometime. Sometime you will miss that track also. Right?
It's kind of sad that people, when they think they are on the right path, but maybe on the wrong path. So, for example, I know somebody who is a friend of my dad, whose kids were my age and we were all friends. He was very religious, very much into following the rituals, but to the extent that he thought he was doing good things. To the extent his family suffered tremendously. So at some point you think, is that a good thing or a bad thing? The kids now will not go to a temple because they have been so suffered through this entire process. His wife suffered because of his need to do a certain thing a certain way. He probably thinks he's on the right path, was on the right path. He's still alive and still doing this and still, and he has no bondage, as in the asuric quality of, you know, human bondage, because for him to follow his ritual is far more important than to give up for any particular reason, including grandkids or including... How do we, you know?
In South India, probably Guruvayur could be one of the best temple. The chief priest was arrested and put into jail with a charge of stealing the bimba inside. Later it was found it was not correct, but he suffered a lot. We had a person who was a Saptaham expert throughout his life. He was doing Saptaham and the end of his life, he said, these are all rubbish, useless, I don't want. So you don't know when you will change. These are all test process.
But he is not bad per se. He's just, his lifestyle is difficult anybody to live with.
Yeah, for anyone, the lifestyle may be difficult, but he is enjoying by himself is good enough.
To what extent?
What is that enjoyment is undefined. Suppose somebody is living in Himalaya We will say he is actually suffering. Is it really suffering or enjoying?
No, he is.
That's good enough.
He is putting people who are...
There is no bondage. So he is not worried about them.
But so they have the bondage.
The bondage is with them, but not he.
His wife is expected to... I mean, he will starve the entire day and his wife...
See, understand, God himself is meeting his mother after birth, after 11 years. Lord Krishna himself has the problem. Lord Krishna had a wife, but he had a lover. Where is the bondage? If he always think about his wife, what would have happened to lover? If he always think about lover, what would have happened to wife?
So what was his wife supposed to do?
That's
she
what
was the one suffering.
The, what is the suffering is the big problem. See, suffering is all inside us. That's what I'm saying. It's only between the buddhi and the manas. There is a Muslim who has got 100 wives or maybe 23 wives and 100 children living in same house. None of them are suffering. They are all happy. Huh? That is the custom. The suffering and the happiness is a big custom.
But sir...
It's a culture. For somebody which is in practice, when somebody does in slightly different style, you think it is a suffering.
I still, I mean, he wants to go, let's say, to some Purima, goes to one temple and he drives his wife. And she has to go from one city to another city. When she wants to, in a bondage, she wants to spend some time with her grandkids in the US. And he has his particular Purima that he wants to be in that particular place. And he wouldn't come. And even if he came for a month. And even if he came, his kids have to... I don't know. It just seems like...
Yeah, small, stubborn style of... Yeah, small, stubborn... we have a professor, Professor Kannan in Hyderabad University. He will only go for lectures if the well water is supplied to him for cooking. Imagine... What is the difference between well water and water from the well or pipe? If the water comes from pipe, he will not cook in that. In Cochin, when we wanted to come, we had to identify some house. There was no house with well water. He was staying somewhere far. And then from there, he has to be, got to the... Otherwise,
but
university...
He's living a sattvic life.
See, that is what I'm saying. That's a culture. That's a tradition given to him. It is a practice given to him which made him like that. That's a satsang.
Which is what I'm saying.
Which may be...
Which is kind of sad to know that you lead your life thinking you're leading a sattvic life. But maybe not. Maybe you are putting so many people under...
That is what I'm saying. See, whether you are doing it with your manas and the buddhi associated, you decide you are doing, there is no conflict for him, there is no problem for him. Even for some people, doing it, they themselves have a conflict, then he is in shucham.
I got it.
You understood? It is not that, why are you feeling so bad because you think that this is not logical.
No, I get it. It's the Savari example. She gives after tasting because she's doing it right.
For somebody else, it may not. See, assume a couple comes to you from India and you believe that you are taking care of them. So immediately you go and picks up and then give them a rest in your house. But they felt they don't want to stay with anybody. They want to be in some hotel. You are thinking you are doing good. Correct? But for them, it may be a bondage. When somebody comes to your house, you are giving coffee. Have it. I have to, you think that, coffee is the best food available. Somebody has to have coffee. But for the person, it seems coffee I don't like. It's a punishment for me. See, between people to people, it can happen. That's all unimportant. What is more important is, between my manas and my buddhi, if it is good, I am only worried about me, which I am not disturbing anybody else. Who is the disturbing? Why the other person being thinking that it is a disturbance?
The person
because of the bondage. That's why here it says bondage is the biggest problem.
But sir, going off on Usha's example, and we've talked about this before, from your previous lectures, we say that what this gentleman did is actually not right, because as a grihastha, he has given up his duty. So isn't he actually accumulating papa?
Yeah.
I mean,
no, he's not necessarily given up his duty. He still works. He still provides.
Everything must be given.
He still does all.
Yeah.
But he lives such a rigid life
that
makes. I mean, to the point, his children are atheists. They do not want to go to heaven.
But that also makes me wonder. Is he following the grihastha properly, or is he, I mean, I guess he is providing for his family, doing the basic.
See, there is a limit for your grihastha, and after that you can get rid of that.
Okay.
Just because you married and produced a child, it doesn't mean throughout the life you live for them. I think for such matter, America is a better example than India. Once they are on, go. Correct.
I think you made it sound this grihastha thing as if a bondage itself. When you describe following, you have to be grihastha, otherwise if you're not doing all this, you accumulate papa and all that. No, I didn't mean it in that sense. But maybe at least for the first 15-20 years that you're supposed to be in grihastha, you give your all for your family. Right. And then you do your...
You give all for your family, but that's then it. You do your... and you live your life, and his life was so rigid on that aspect that his wife had to turn her life around to take care of it.
I like the way you said it, your manas and intellect.
That is more important. See, we are in conflict.
So he doesn't feel there is no conflict.
Them
to suffering.
Yeah.
So he's not doing anything.
He's not
so
doing.
I get that.
And he also is happy his kids are atheists. Atheists are more stronger sometimes.
They are. Their kids are good.
Yeah. Why you are called an atheist? Because I don't believe in God and rituals. That means they know there is a God and ritual. That knowing itself is a belief. See, why are you against something? Because you know there is something there. Actually, God feels atheists are more better. There are a lot of sannyasins who says atheists are much far better than the so-called believers.
But what if atheists go out of their way to insult God and...
There is no insult to God.
You don't have to follow any rituals or the belief that there is a higher being.
Okay.
But you just be nice to the human beings the way they are today.
Yes.
So
see, the
religious people are sometimes much more cruel than atheists.
The difference is only you are trying to derive logic in that, then many things will become false. Somebody says that I don't believe in God, I have not seen him. There are many things you have to believe which you have not seen. I love my mother, but I cannot see that love. Anybody can show that the love? You have taste for water. Can you show the taste for water? Not possible. You can only feel it. It's a feeling inside you. Right? So, and some people love others, but they may not show. Correct? Somebody may love it, but you may not show it. Nothing wrong.
I believe in him.
Yes.
That gentleman is exactly that.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for bringing the question up.
No, many people have such examples, but we don't discuss sometimes. That's only the problem. We know a lot of people who, and what is being told is, these are all test process. The God himself will test you at what point of time. When should I show my strength? When everything goes smooth, I don't have to show my ability to drive. When the road is not good, the vehicle is not good, the traffic is too bad. If I'm driving perfect, then I'm a good driver. So all your qualities, whether Asurik or Devik or all these, have to come out with a lot of test process.
And I guess the only way to pass the test is to not have bondage. Looks like. Is it?
It's very easy to say not to have bondage. That's why I took the example of, the guru. I don't know whether I told you the story of an old man having a horse came into his house, and then it's all the not having bondage, no? That's what makes him happy. The time you have bondage, finished. It is mine, it is mine, it is mine, it is mine. That's when it goes, you feel upset. But still that can be there, but for smaller duration.
Yeah.
Soon after that, can you take a deep breath and say, I'm all right, I'm fine? If that is not there, you are not a human being.
Detachment.
Yeah, you have to have that humanness inside. That means consideration for somebody else. But don't...
That man didn't have consideration for somebody else. Because he was...
He may have, but he may not show. If he is not having, he will never come back to his own house. He is coming back to his house. But he may not show it. Maybe immediately there is a worry comes, he will say, Narayana, 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 Narayana. Because he believes that.
It's also a choice for the other person in the relationship. I mean, speaking of the matter.
And it's all patched.
You don't have to, not stuck to something.
Yeah.
You move on and then they do their
thing. And we look at a family, you will know husband and wife, they are supplementary to each other. If one is not, the other will take care. I'm sure if the mother was not taking care, father would have been more. One has to do this job 100%. It's a balancing. That's how the family goes. Somebody is there. You can see some family where wife is more authoritative. She is the ruler. Then the other fellow will be a servant. Otherwise, they cannot survive. Maybe they will take care of all the activities of one side, the rest of the side, you know. Children also know to whom should go and then complain. There is no point in talking to my father. Mother is better. Everything will be cleaned up, right? It keeps happening.
But that statement was not correct. In some houses, wives will be stronger. In some houses, husband will be stronger. 100% of the cases, wives will be stronger.
I don't know, have you travelled in Northeast? You are from West. See, we in Northeast, it is the wife who runs the family and the husband is only a person who will just sit and then listen to the wife. Nothing else. That is accepted as a culture. But in some other part, it is not accepted. There it is accepted. You will see when we are crossing the Brahmaputra river, you will see a single lady who will be pulling all the vehicles on the other side. Her husband will be looking at the other side, powerful lady doing all this.
And not just that, Dr. TPS, there is a research saying if a lady is powerful in the home, home is always a better place.
But then the husband has to be powerful in society, otherwise he has no value anywhere.
that's exactly what it says. Like, I might not be able to translate it properly. What it says is that lady will be very tough at home, but she will make sure that others will treat her husband as a king in the society.
That's what I'm saying. That's always it is true. Right. But we have Iron Lady. She was both the places she was powerful. Eh? She was at home also a tough master. She was very good in both. Right? Dvai Bhuta Sorgau Lokesmin.
Dvai Bhuta Sorgau Lokesmin.
Deva Asura Evacha.
Deva Asura Evacha.
Devo Vistarashaha Proktaha.
Devo Vistarashaha Proktaha.
Asuram Parthame Srunu.
Asuram Parthame Srunu.
So Lord says, I already explained the Devo Vistarashaha Proktaha. In detail I explained to you the divine quality. Now listen about Asuras. Right? Dvai Bhuta Sorgau Lokesmin. There are two varieties of creations. Deva, Asura, Evacha. There are two different types. Let us see how he is going to explain this. The Bhajagovindam is a great example for this. Why in the outside world you will only see the Asura people. And similarly the Upadesha Saram also. The Patana Karanam is the Gadi Nirodhakam, where your path is, the path towards your self-realization is stuck. That is what stops you. They are all mudha. The Mudha people are all the people, such people. So they're all uneducated. Therefore, you must get educated to get realization. That's what both scriptures says. Pravrittim cha nivrittim cha jana na viduhu asurah na shaucham
na
api chacharo na satyam teshu vidyate pravrittim cha nivrittim cha. Pravritti is action. Nivritti is
inaction.
No action or no way to do that, or doing it wrongly. I know what is to be done, what is not to be done. Nivritti and pravritti. Jana na viduhu asuraha. Two type of the people, these two people. What do? They do pravritti and do the wrong pravritti. Good pravritti or no pravritti is also a wrong pravritti. Because as far as God is concerned, you have to be in action always. Without karma, nobody stays. So without karma, if you are staying, that is also bad. Or doing something wrong is also bad. Na shaucham. No shaucham. No purity. No cleanliness. Naachi na acharam. Cha acharaho. There is no achara. There is no conduct. Acharam is which is as per culture the way you lead. That is also not there. That's why I said it is bounded with the achara. Anything which is followed by a community, followed by a tradition, followed by your family, if you don't do it, then only it becomes bad. Otherwise, everything is accepted. Na satyam teshu vidyate. Satyam, truthfulness. If that is not there, no truthfulness.
And when we say saucham, we are not just talking about internal, we are also talking about external cleanliness too, right?
Everything. Sapta Shuddhi. You yourself, it is not forced by somebody else. It is by yourself. Now the way you eat, the way you cook. Like we have, one of my guru is from the Narayana Tapovana Swami. He takes classes for how to keep your kitchen clean. If you don't wash your bartan on the same day. Traditionally, it was not the night after the dinner. If it not wash, it is not kept inside your house. It is kept outside the house. You're not supposed to keep it inside. No vessel unwashed is kept inside your house. That's a rule. No food is reused. Now, today, everybody keeps in the fridge and then takes it back and do it. That's actually not part of our life. Not because there was no fridge. It says old food is not good. That's it. Reheating is not permitted.
So now I may be contradicting myself, but going back to Ushaji's story, is it possible that the person who's following the rituals is following saucham, so it's actually good again? Rituals.
See, but always in Bharatiya Shastram, it's a beautiful way of saying you have to follow your saucham provided you are in your own village. With your own tradition. The time you are out of your village, it can be half. When you are in travel, it can be 1/4. When you are in somebody's house, you can get rid of all the rituals. You can. You cannot do, no? Assume that you are in... What is that rituals is also not well defined because each place and time it is redefined. You cannot say in Kerala, everybody has to be the topless... Take bath every day. You cannot put that ritual in Jammu Kashmir. He will not live. Right?
I have an example for that. When we were in England, there was a Mormon family that visited us. And they didn't visit us. They met him at the airport. And they exchanged business cards and they buy Cummins and James. So they wanted... So Friday they met him. On Sunday, they called us and said... We are just passing by your town, can we come and meet you? I said, sure. Five adult kids, five big grown-up kids and two parents, they were tracing their routes. So when they came at 7 o'clock in the evening, I was going to buy some food to give them for dinner. And they said, in our religion, we do not eat outside food on Sundays.
Hmm.
But we have come to your house, and if you choose to serve us that way, it's acceptable, it's okay for us. So even they have some such rituals where
yes.
they don't follow.
This is Acharanushtana.
Acharanushtana.
But if we were to serve them and we bought the outside food, they, it would have been okay as part of their religion.
She ended up cooking.
I ended up cooking. How can I break that's their...
That is what in Bharatiya Shastra, anything which is extreme, too tough, too tight is not what is accepted. You have to be flexible. Flexibility is what is great. You will see many places. Pravrtim cha nivartim cha
Pravrtim cha nivartim cha
Janana viduhu asuraha
Janana viduhu asuraha
Na shaucham na pichacharo
Na shaucham na pichacharo
Na satyam teshu vidyate
Na satyam teshu vidyate
Acharam itself is which is in practice. Yadyat acharyati srashta tatta devetarochana sayat pramanam kurute logastadani vartate. If some acharya is doing something, you can quote him and refer and then go. Like the rule, you can always quote what happened in the earlier court in some other case. Therefore, the rule has to be like this. Right? So, if somebody has done it, you can take it as an example and then follow it. Because he is an acharya. Once you consider somebody is your acharya, whatever he does, you can follow. You don't have to check anywhere else. So, acharam is what is the culture. Acharam is what is somebody has to follow. That's it. But then sometime what happens is, acharam is mistook. I remember telling some example in one of my lecture. We had a Ayyappa Puja. Ayyappa Puja, they make aravana. And the priest had severe cold. So, what he does is, he uses his towel. And he washes and then keep it on top of the lid so that it will get dried. 2-3 years, same pujari came. He has always cold. Running nose. The fourth time when some other pujari came, he has not put the towel on top of the bartha. So the grihastha was asking, why you are not keeping towel on top? Because that's a ritual. Anything which is done is considered as a ritual, right? Nobody knows what is to be done. There are many such stories. You know, there was a small cat in the house who was running around and the puja was getting disturbed. So immediately the pujari said, take a bucket and then close the cat and then keep it in the corner. Then we start the puja. So second time when pujari came, they brought cat from somewhere and closed it and kept in the bucket. Because you don't ask the reason for doing it, right? Appaya Dikshitar is a great writer. He writes a lot of such jokes. He is a person who criticizes and he is a great devotee. He said once he was going for bath in the sea where he had a lot of ornaments, and what he did is he made a small dig and then put the ornaments inside the sand, and then a stick which he used to for walking stick he put there, and then he put his cloth on top so that when he come back he will see where this. He went for bath, by the time he came back, he saw many places, lot of sticks and lot of clothes. People do these sort of acharas because you don't ask questions. Which was the movie which we have seen recently? Somebody has fallen down and making mock of a Swamiji's tradition.
Dharma Sankat
Pe. There was an arch in which one of the devotee was coming, by mistake he hit somewhere, he has fallen. So, as he fallen, he stood up and then started walking. So, everybody is falling there. Because they thought that is the ritual, first before entering the... Right. అసత్యం అప్రదిష్టం తే
అసత్యం అప్రదిష్టం తే
జగతాహు
జగతాహు
అనీశ్వరం
అనీశ్వరం
అపరస్పర సంభూతం
అపరస్పర సంభూతం
కిమన్యత్ కామహైతుకం
కామహైతుకం
అసత్యం అప్రదిష్టం. Asatyam is what is not having truth. Apradishtam is what we explained now, without any reason. Many people just follow without any reason. Apradishtam te jagat ahuhu, jagat the world, ahuhu, they keep saying, they keep proclaiming, they keep spreading, anishwaram, without a specific the heavenly activity there. Ishwarigata is what is a heavenly activity. Anishwaram, there is no concept of God itself. It is not for a purpose. Anything which is for a purpose, for a good karma, is called Ishwarigata. So people just do many things, say many things without a purpose. Aparaspara sambhutam, without a cause, without a purpose. Without a real creative activity, people keep repeating many things. Kimanyat kama hetukam. Why are they doing it? If you look at it, you understand there is only one kama in them. What is the kama? Some desire. What is the desire? To get something, they keep doing it. Without understanding what is the real. Kim anyat. What else? Nothing else is there other than kamam, desire. They just do it because of a desire. అసత్యం అప్రదిష్టం తే జగతాహు అనీశ్వరం అపరస్పర సంభూతం కిమన్యత్ కామహైతుకం నథింగ్ ఎల్స్ అదర్ దెన్ డిజైర్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ లీడింగ్ దమ్. That's what happened to Duryodhana also. When Gandhari herself came and asked, why are you doing all this? He says, Janami dharmam, nachame pravritti. I know what is dharmam, pravrittim cha nivrittim cha. Same word is coming there. Janami dharmam, nachame pravritti. I know what is to be done, I am not able to do it. Janami adharmam, I know what is not to be done. Nachame nivrti, I am not able to stop doing it. Kena api kamena hrudisthitena yatha niyuktosi tatha karomi. My kamam, desire in my manas says, you do it. And that could be for power, that could be for position, that could be for wealth, that could be for entertainment, that could be for your self-enjoyment with all the indriyas, which has no social purpose. That's what here also he says. Such anishwara job is considered as asurigam. Ninth one. Etam drishtima vishtabhya.
Etam drishtima
vishtabhya.
Nashtatma no.
Nashtatma no.
Alpabuddhayaha.
Alpabuddhayaha.
Prabhavandyu.
Prabhavandyu.
ప్రభవంద్యుగ్రకర్మణాః క్షయాయ జగతో అహితా ఏతాం దృష్టిమా దాట్ సచ్ థింగ్స్ దృష్టిమా విచ్ ఈస్ ఇన్ అవర్ వ్యూ. దృష్టి ఈస్ నాట్ సీయింగ్ హియర్, దృష్టి ఈస్ ద ఫిలాసఫికల్ వర్డ్. దట్ మీన్స్ వాట్ యు ఆర్ వ్యూయింగ్, వాట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ యువర్ వ్యూ, which is holding avishtabhya, which is stopping you from seeing it. Not necessarily what is seeing, what is around you, that's the meaning here. Nashtatma, where you feel it is lost, it is misdirected, it is not coming towards you. And atma, that in your atma. And sulpa buddhi, it is not full buddhi, sulpa buddhi. The sulpa buddhi is what is practically seen by somebody, you just follow. They are all sulpa buddhis. You are not thinking, you are not using your logic, you are not critically analyzing things. Prabha Vandyu, that which comes out as Ugra, the cruel, Karmanaha, cruel actions. Because of your Silpabuddhi, without seeing, just following somebody else, which are all what is happening around you, which is becoming a, not a divine activity, Kshaya. That's a destructive process, Jagato Hitaha, which is not the hitam of the world. That means for a common purpose, for a larger purpose, you are not doing it.
Good of the
larger group. That's what I said. Which is correct, which is not correct, is decided by what is acceptable to the common people in the whole Janma society. Right? So I may be not good to my family, but I am doing a greater thing for a larger community whom I consider is more important. He is considered as divine. For his family, he may be Asurik. But for a larger community, he is divine. That's why Gandhi, My Father is a bad movie. But Gandhi movie is a good movie. Which says Mahatma Gandhi is great. Right? For that also, we gave some small example yesterday. Like the example which you are telling, somebody wanted only that food. I don't know whether you were, I don't know which session which I said. Mahatma Gandhi traveled only in third class. But he was not traveling with 90 passengers in a 60-seater, crushed inside. Whenever he wanted to travel, the whole bogie was booked for him.
He used to live in a village. Yeah. And Sarojini Devi used to go and tell him, yeah, to make you poor is more expensive.
That's what I'm saying. He said, he's an expensive poor man.
Because they had to clean up the entire
thing. For him to have a goat milk, the goat milk was costing only 2 rupees. For the food for the goat itself was 10 rupees cost. Those days, not now. And wherever he goes, the goat has to go. Correct? Because being stubborn sometimes is very harsh. No? You can be flexible. So, Jagato Hitaha Ahitaha Chayam, the goodness for the bigger people can be your motive. Then you are a divine person. Etam drishtima vishvashtabhya.
Etam drishtima
vishvashtabhya.
Nashtatmano.
Nashtatmano.
Alpabuddhayaha.
Alpabuddhayaha.
Prabhavandyugra karma karmanaha. Kshayaya jagato ahitaha.
Kshayaya jagato ahitaha.
Kamamasritya dushpuram.
Kamamasritya dushpuram.
Dambhamana madanyitaha.
Dambhamana madanyitaha.
Mohat grihitva.
Mohad grihitva.
Asad grahan.
Asad
grahan.
Sarvatande.
Pravartante.
Pravartande.
Pravartante.
Ashuchi vrataha.
Ashuchi
vrataha.
Kamam asrida dushpuram. Kamam. Again, desire. Many places it is mistranslated as sex and lust, because English translation generally does it. But in Vaidikam, Veda Shastra, kama doesn't mean sex. It means desire. The desire can be for anything. Unstoppable desire for learning is also a kama. No? You do anything to get something, that is called kama. Kamam asritaha, which is supported to dushpuram, which is not acceptable. So you get close to the extent of doing anything for any such things. Dambham, ahanda, arrogance, and manam, feeling proud of yourself, not Ahankaram, ahanda. Madanyita, Madam is too much of head weight, for which you do many things, right?
Arrogant.
Because of the head weight only, you are becoming arrogant. Mohat. Why? Because they are in moham. Grihitva. Grihitva is attachment. You want to get that. You stay with that moham. Asat grahan. And what do? You get all the things around you. I want. That sort of feeling people have. Pravartante. They do job. They are very active only in one thing. For what? I want. My kama. My desire. My ahanta. My proud. Ashuchi vrta. And what do? They impure all the other people. Getting is not bad. But what happens is they impure the other people.
It's like a definition for Trump.
Kama-ma-srutya-duṣpūryam. Dambha-ma-na-madhan-vita. Mohat. Grihitva asad-grahān. Pravartante. Ashuchi-vṛta. 100% sure Krishna must be feeling. He went as a messenger asking Duryodhana to get little bit of place, one small country, we will not fight war. But he was arrogant. So when he is describing, he was in mind. This is what his quality. Therefore he says, he is an asura. And here you are a deva. So deva with a rajasic quality is good. You must fight and then kill them. The ultimate aim is that. To provoke him to fight the war. Chindam aparimeyam cha.
Chindam aparimeyam.
Chindam aparimeyam cha.
Yeah.
Krishna himself could have fought the war in 2 minutes and finished it.
Yes.
But he chose not to.
But then we will not do anything. We will only become bhakta and say, let God do everything. We are all the hands and the senses of God. The message is for people to do. God should not do anything. He should only guide us. That is what Krishna avatar. In previous avatar, he did it. As Rama, he fought himself. He not only fought for himself, to help somebody else also, he fought. He killed.
Sir, another question.
That's what Anand wanted sometime, right? A comparison between the Rama and the Krishna.
Yes.
Yeah.
Another question. So, you say, of course, Duryodhana had the Asuric qualities and of course Arjuna has some of the Devi qualities. What about the other Kauravas? What about Bhishma or Karna? I mean, they probably had a mix of both or...
That is what I am saying. Standing beside, doing something, being a supportive is not anything to do with your basic qualities. Every soldier of India who is fighting war in the border. Yesterday was Kargil, Vijay Divas. I was part of that. I supplied maps throughout the... 3,000 maps were from my own hand. Right? All the soldiers, many of them killed. Right? Whose? That was not their fault. And whom they are killing? Again, their own brothers who are standing there. They are not Asuric. So killing or dying or standing beside supporting the government is not part of your job. Just because I became a police, I will have to beat someone. Because the order says I have to beat someone. I am a CRPF fellow. When there is an accelerated movement or maybe a emergency, my job is to beat somewhere and then fire somewhere or demolish a colony. I may not feel that I am doing something wrong. Because in your job, what you are doing as a job is called a professional dharma. I am an advocate. My job is when somebody does a mistake and then come to me, I should not give a preaching like a priest saying that you should not do anything wrong. Advocate has to get money from him and then argue for him. Even if he is a murderer, I must prove in the court that he never did anything wrong. That is my professional dharma. Outside he has got a family dharma, but don't try to do the same professional dharma in the family. Correct. So each place the dharma is different. So there is nothing wrong. So all the people, that's why I took the example of Bhishma, who stayed. Bhishma is almost a rupam of Krishna himself. But he is in the other side. So what is to be done? He has to do it. No other go. He has to obey the rule.
But he had this internal turmoil.
100%
he
had.
Which tells me that he was doing, he knows he was doing
he wrong. Knows he was doing wrong because of a great mistake he has done in his childhood. No? When he was young, Amba Ambiga Ambaliga. He kidnapped 3 girls.
What did he do?
He kidnapped 3 girls. Read. Amba Ambiga Ambaliga Bhishma. So he had a curse. So he has to undergo that curse. So anybody who does something in your life or does in your earlier janma, definitely, that's why you should read the book called Mahabharata Unbelievable Mahabharata. There is a great book. Everything is contradicting from the Dharma Shastra which we write. Then the author concludes saying that it is because you have not read the previous story. You feel it is contradicting, it is wrong because you don't know the reason behind happening so. Mahabharata is unbelievable. That's a beautiful book. That's where I started learning Mahabharata. That will tell you a lot of such stories. Why Bhima did it, Bhishma did it, there is an answer. Why Bhima is like this, there is an answer. Why Arjuna is like this, there is an answer. And you know that this Panchali loved Karna? She never loved any of these Pandavas. Her full desire was for Karna, and she used to meet Karna every night. Her Dharmaputra knows this. So there are a lot of inner stories in Mahabharata which you really read and understand. You see, it talks about today's world. It's not talking about a thing which happened 5,000 years back, which happens in many families around this globe everywhere. And therefore, what is the lesson which you have to learn to derive from that to lead your life is what is being taught here. Chindam. Chinda is not the normal thought process. Here, chinda is worry. It is not care, it is anxiety. Here, chinda is anxiety. Aparimeyam cha. Because it is, the next word is the qualification for that. It is not parimeyam, it is aparimeyam. Limitless. There is no solution for this. And cha means and always. And pralayandam. What is pralayandam? They will not stop worrying until death. Pralayam is death here for self. For me, the pralayam is my end. So pralayandam. Upasritaha. They always take refuge of someone. If I did something, I'll say, he told me, then I did it. That's why I did it. Finished, no? See, nobody does anything because somebody else told. It is only he himself tells him and he does it. We only try to find out somebody who will support me for the job and we drag them inside. That's what we do. I did it because I wanted to do it. But what do? I will first ask Vijay, will you support me? Yeah, support. I said, Vijay told me, that's why I did it. If anything goes wrong, he is responsible. That's it. And if he says no, I will ask somebody else. I know that, no, other person who will not agree with you, I'll find him as a reason. He told me, that's why I did it. Finished. Correct? That is why we say committee is the best thing where we can find a fault. The committee told us it's not me. Actually, I wanted to do it. But the committee says it's not supportive. No. Committee commits nothing anyway. Pralayandam upasritaha. Till the end, they keep fighting somebody else. Kamam. Kamo. Kamam. Ubabhoga paramaha. Their kamam, desire, is like an ubhabhogam. What is ubhabhogam? Without that, they cannot live. Bhogam is egabuktam mahayogi, dibuktam mahabhogi, tribuktam maharogi, chaturbuktam mahadrogi. So bhogam is I want, I want, I want. If you eat twice, you are a bhogi. Anything you want second time, you are a bhogi. Not once. Once it is okay, fine. I am satisfied. No, again, again. That is bhogam. bhogam paramaha, kamam ubhabhogam paramaha, to the extreme end. Etavat, that is how that, iti nishchitaha, that is how they decide and say that this is what is. They decide that. This my desire, I want, so I am doing it. They don't worry about anything else. And their desire is where they are upasritaha. Until the end, their upasritam, their desire is what their end. They will never stop. Their mind, the desire keeps on increasing. I want. There is no end.
This feels like many of us.
No, that could be for different. This kamam could be for many things. That it could be for power, that could be for position, that could be for money, that could be for knowledge, that could be for food. And any of these you have, your life becomes only that. You will not worry about something else.
So this is what he's saying, asura quality.
Most of the things he is telling asura quality. Not to do. Chintam aparimeyam cha. Pralayantam upasritaha. Kama ubhaboga parama. Etavat
upabhoga parama.
Etavat iti nishchitaha. So if you start counting up to the 11th version, we will get lot of qualities which are for Asurik. Right? Now 12th one. Ashapasha. Shitaihi buddha. Kama krodha parayanaha.
Kama krodha parayanaha.
Ihande kama bhogartham.
Ihande kama bhogartham.
Anyayena
Arthasanjayan
wealth. So he is behind getting money. And what they will discuss, nothing wrong in being behind money. If you have money only, you can give to somebody else. Every sacrifice, the first step is to acquire. If you acquire only, you can give. So acquisition is not bad. But they only think about it, only talk about it, nothing else. They only discuss this, nothing else.
This is about the material.
Material. The wealth. Acquiring wealth. Asha Pasham. Pasham is the thread. Asha is desire. And you are on a desire of thread. You will never stop. You keep on pulling it. Asha Pasha Shatairhi. You shataihi, hundreds of bondage with the desire. It's like a thread given to you, you cannot get rid of it. You are on to that. Bandhaha, you are bounded to that. Ashapasham. Ashapasham is a normal word used. Take me away from the ashapasham. Because one after the other. The thread is like that. It is tinned, right? No thread is a single thread. It is twisted and then kept, made. So you are within that. You cannot get rid of it. Kama krodha parayana. What is that you are parayana? You are dedicated to yourself in kamam and krotham. If you don't get finished, you get angry.
Krotham is anger.
Anger. Because of kamam, you get anger just because you don't get. That is what happens to politicians. That's what happens to the people who are the power mongers and the wealth mongers. Lust, everywhere, if you are not satisfied, your desire finished. The anger comes there. Ihande, in that, what is that? Who is that hotler who died recently in Tamil Nadu?
Saravanabhan.
Not that he is not rich, because he is just behind the money. Not 30, 40 cities in India, he has not enough. All the Gulf countries, he has got not enough. Expanding, nothing wrong. But then, he also wanted his manager's wife. Because somebody said, if you marry manager's wife, you will become more richer.
Astrologer. Is that true?
Yeah. I worked with one of the richest men in India. One of the richest men. I was an advisory board in the educational project, CSR project he was doing. He used to tell, you take anything from me except my calculator. Because he keeps on calculating. His aim is in 2050, I have to become the 13th richest man in the world.
How could the astrologer say such a despicable thing about...
Because he gets money.
Oh.
Any astrologer, he knows, he looks at the pocket. And he will tell what is, what they will give him money.
It's all a test, you know.
Asha Pasha Shatairhi Buddha Baddha Kama Krodha Parayanaha Ihande Kama Bhogartham. The whole Iham, the whole effort he does is only one, Kama Bhoga Artham. His desire has to get satisfied. Only for his desire he will do anything. Anyaye na anyaye na. Nyayam is just. Anyayam is no just. So anyayena, without all the anyayam, artha sanjayan, he will do anything good to get money. That's it. Right? Asha apasha shatairhi.
Asha apasha shatairhi.
Buddha baddhaha.
Baddhaha.
Kama krodha parayanaha.
Kama krodha parayanaha.
Ihande kama bhogartham.
Ihande kama bhogartham.
Anyaye na. Anyaye na.
Anyaye na.
Artha sanjayan.
Artha sanjayan.
Don't read it as anyaye na artha sanjayan. That means you don't want money and nyayam. Anyaye na.
Anyaye na.
Artha sanjayan. Idam,
idam,
adhya,
adhya,
maya labdham,
maya labdham,
imam,
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 prapsye manoradham,
prapsye manoradham.
Is there a idam?
Idam,
actually wrong. Imam, imam is the correct
one.
Imam, some text it is imam. In my book it is idam, but then it is not matching. So I was spending some time today to find out. Imam is
mine
correct.
Idam.
Idam is wrong. The first one is idam, second one is imam. Imam
is today, right?
Hmm?
Here is today.
Yeah. Imam. Imam prapsye
manoradham.
Imam prapsye manoradham.
Idamastida mabi me.
Idamastida mabi me.
Bhavishyati puna.
Bhavishyati
punardhanam.
Punardhanam.
Idam adhya maya labdham. This idam. This adhya today. Maya labdham. To me, I get it. I got. I am the receiver for this. What? Imam. This. Prapsye. Which gets closer to me. That means I am acquiring manoratham with my desire. Manorathaihi. Many places it came. Idam asti. Idam asti. This is that. Api mine. Api me. This is what is mine now. Bhavishyanti punardhanam. In future, punardhanam. Again this comes. Now I got this. Now what I want? Now my mind is satisfied. This much money makes me happy. But not enough. I want this much more. Idam asti, idam api me. As much as I got now, again I want in the next moment. Then when I get next moment, if two moments you add together, it becomes double. I want in the next moment that much again. It's like a progression. I want to keep on adding. Right? Itam adhyamaya labdham.
Itam adhyamaya labdham.
Imam prapsye manoratham.
Imam prapsye
manoratham. In the manas he keep on adding it. Like a cumulative process. Itam asti itam abhi me. భవిష్యంతి పునర్ధనం. పునర్ధనం, కీప్ ఆన్ యాడింగ్. పునర్ధనం ఈస్ క్యుములేటివ్, రైట్? దర్ ఆర్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ శ్లోకాస్ విచ్ ఐ కెన్ రెఫర్ టు. ఐఎమ్ స్కిప్పింగ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. యూ గో టు ద సెకండ్ చాప్టర్, దర్ ఆర్ విచ్ సేస్ ద కామసుఖి ఈస్ వన్ హూ డజంట్ గెట్ నో శాంతి ఆప్నోతి న కామ న కామం. దే డోంట్ బికమ్ సాటిస్ఫైడ్. శాంతి ఈజ్ సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్. వితౌట్ కామన్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ సాటిస్ఫైడ్. దే వాంట్ సంథింగ్. ద ధర్మశాస్త్ర, దట్ ఈస్ వర్ ఇన్ ద బేసిక్ ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ థింగ్ వాట్ యూ సెడ్, హౌ టు బీ ఏ యోగి, హౌ టు బీ గెట్ రిడ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ దీస్ అండ్ ఆల్ ద గుడ్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ టోల్డ్ ఇన్ ద బిగినింగ్. బట్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ హీ వాంట్ టు టెల్ ఈఫ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ వాట్ యు ఆర్, దీస్ ఆర్ ద పీపుల్ హు ఆర్ యువర్ ఎనిమీస్. ఇఫ్ యు టాక్ అబౌట్ ద అసురాస్ ఇన్ ద బిగినింగ్ వితౌట్ యువర్ క్వాలిటీ బికమింగ్ స్టెబిలైజ్డ్, నౌ అర్జున ఈజ్ నాట్ ఎ వరీడ్ పర్సన్. నౌ హిస్ వరీస్ హావ్ గాన్. అస్యూమ్ దట్ సంబడీ సేస్ యు ఆర్ ఎన్ యు ఆర్ మీటింగ్ విత్ ఎన్ అసుర వితౌట్ యూ బీయింగ్ స్ట్రాంగ్, దెన్ ఇట్ బికమ్స్ అ ప్రాబ్లమ్. సో వాట్ ఈస్ ఫస్ట్ డన్ ఈస్ వీ టీచ్ డ్రైవింగ్, వీ టీచ్ హౌ టు ఫైట్ విత్ ఎవరిబడి, దెన్ షో ద కౌంటర్ పార్ట్ విచ్ ఆర్ ద ప్లేసెస్ వేర్ దే ఆర్ హైడింగ్, వాట్ ఈస్ రాంగ్ విత్ దమ్, విచ్ ఆర్ ద ఎక్విప్మెంట్స్ విచ్ దే హ్యావ్. సో ద ఆసురికత ఈస్ బీయింగ్ టోల్డ్ అండ్ హియర్ దట్ ఆల్సో ఈస్ నాట్ టోల్డ్ యాజ్ యువర్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ లైక్ దట్. ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఎ ధర్మశాస్త్ర ఈస్ బీయింగ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్. అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్ ద రీజన్, బేసిక్ రీజన్ ఫర్ విచ్ యు ఆర్ ఫైటింగ్. దిస్ హ్యాస్ టు బి టోల్డ్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ యు ఆర్ వార్ ద నో వెపన్స్ ఆర్ ఇన్సైడ్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్. ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ హోల్డింగ్ ద వెపన్, ఫస్ట్ మై జాబ్ ఈస్ టు మేక్ యూ టు హోల్డ్ ద వెపన్, దెన్ టెల్ యూ హుమ్ టు కట్. సో ద ఫస్ట్ అప్ టు 10th వాస్ ద ప్రాక్టికల్ లెసన్ ఫర్ మేకింగ్ యూ టు బికమ్ స్ట్రాంగ్, రైట్? అప్ టు 11th అండ్ 12th వాస్ ఎ మోడరేట్ వన్. 13th ఆన్వర్డ్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ధర్మశాస్త్ర టు హుమ్ యు ఆర్ ఫైటింగ్. అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్ యువర్ రోల్ టు మేక్ దిస్ వరల్డ్ స్టెబిలైజ్డ్, బికాస్ ఫర్ ఎ బెటర్ పర్పస్, ఫర్ ఎ గుడ్ పర్పస్ యు ఆర్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్.
Sir, in this shloka, Krishna is telling that do not desire for more. Isn't that against the principle of growth? Like, should you not aim for growth?
No. More, without disturbing anybody else. The basic kama is explained there. Your kama should not be in somebody's trouble.
Okay.
Right? Anything which you do over, even exercise is very good for your health. Adivyayama madakaso jara shardishcha jayati hrudaya dyubarodascha. Over exercise can get you heart attack. Anything which is more is not accepted. Eating is good, but overeating is bad. So anything, your kamam desire is must. Without kamam, nobody lives in this world. Therefore, he said kamam is essential. But then he says, more kamam is not good for you. Without kamam, no desire, then this fellow will not even be there in the war field, right? Correct? He says, your kamam should be like, I think in the second chapter, the aapam from the samudram which is going up. The samudram which has got the water which gets evaporated, how much it goes, there should be a limit. But the sunlight should not make the whole river to vanish without that. Without that you will not get river water, right? The water in the sea and the water available on the ground needs to get evaporated, then it becomes cloud for the rain to come. But sun should not be that hot, make every water on the globe to be evaporated totally. That should not happen. There has to be a limit. That is what is called shanti. With shanti only you should work. Without ashanti should not be there in your desire. Right? The 14th one. Asau maya hatas శత్రుర్
అశౌమః శత్రు
హనీషే చాపరానపి ఈశ్వరో అహమహం భోగీ సిద్ధోహం బలవాన్ సుఖీ అసౌ మయా హతః శత్రుర్ to me, that person who is hataha, finished, hatam is finished, shatrur, enemy, who is destroyed, that person, hanishye chaparanabi, who destroys others, they destroy themselves. Hanishye chaparanabi, though who destroys. Who are destroyed by me are those people who destroy others. Right? Who is that me who is disturbing you, destroying you? Because you are destroying others, I am the one who is destroying you. Or I will destroy all those people who are destroying others. Ishwara, God, who? Aham, aham. Bhogi. Mine. And such bogies will be destroyed by me, the Ishwara. Siddoham. Siddhi is the power. Siddho aham. I have the power and the powerful. And that person who does it, Balavan Sukhi. Balavan Sukhi. And he is the Balavan. He is the Siddhan. He is the Balavan. And he is the Sukhi. Who? Because of I want to be happy, I kill everybody, I destroy everybody, and declare myself as the greatest Balavan, and he is a Sukhi. He is a Sukhi for what? Or he is...
Sukhi for power.
Yeah, Sukhi for power. Sukhi for power, not for self, but by destroying others, you become Sukhi. That's a definition. You can have a desire, but your desire should be limited without disturbing anybody else. So this sloka also explains your question. Right? I can be sukhi, I can be desire, I can have, and satisfying desire is what gives you sukham. Right? In the Purusharthas, kamam, artham, dharmam, moksham. Moksham is happiness. Dharmam is dharmic way. When you do it by destroying somebody else, it is adharmic. So, kamam is the beginning for every wealth, the artha to be acquired. If you don't have a kamam, no artham. You earn only when you have a desire. But then it should be in dharmic way. If it is not dharmic way, this sukham is not the moksha sukham. It is against the moksha sukham, temporary sukham. Asau maya hata shatrur.
Asau maya hata shatrur.
Hanishye.
Chaparanabi
Ishwaro Ahamaham Bhogi
Ishwaro Ahamaham Bhogi
Siddoham Balavan Sukhi
Siddoham Balavan Sukhi
Adhyo Abhijana Vanasmi
Adhyo Abhijana Vanasmi
Ko Anyo Asti
Ko Anyo Asti
Sadrusho maya.
Sadrusho
maya.
Yakshe dasyami.
Yakshe
dasyami.
Modishya.
Modishya.
Ityatnana vimohita.
Ityatnana vimohita.
Adhyo. Adhyo is the proudness of being great, no? Adhyattam. Adhyattam is you feel that you are great. Adhyo abhijana vanasmi. Not that you are proud. You are proud because of your people around you also. That means you have taken birth in a great family. I am rich. I am very great. That sort of feeling. Ko anyo asti drisho maya. Therefore what will happen? Anything around you which is simple, you will not see. Drishyo maya. Nothing will be seen. Ka anyo asti. Everything that else other than this. Yakshe. You sacrifice them. Everything else is nothing for you. You just ignore them. Dasyami. And what do? I may also give you Dasyam. Dasyam means who gets some favor from somebody. So I will give you some money, or maybe I will use my influence to put you into some positions. Modishya. And then what do? Giving is good. Sacrificing is good. But then you boast yourself, I give this to that man. I did that to this man. That modishya is bad. That ekshye dasyami is good. But then modishya, you keep boasting yourself, saying that I did this. And that is what your enjoyment. Right? Ityatnana vimohita. And what are they? They are into ityatnana vimohita. Vimoham. They are into an illusory world. Not the moha valayam. Not into the real world. They live it, this enjoyment, in total ignorance. That's the biggest thing which, who does? Asurika people do. So sometimes you feel that they are doing lot of help to others. But why are they helping? Not helping, they are human. Their helping itself is to boast themselves. So the advertisement, they will use more money than, have you seen?
Actual doing the work.
They may give $100 to the temple, but they may spend $1,000 to advertise it. Correct? There are a lot of people who do annadanam program, but the food cost may be only very less. But the arrangement, advertisement, publicity, all that, they will spend much more than that. Adyo abhijana vana asmi.
Adyo abhijana vana asmi.
Ko anyo asti adrisho maya.
Ko anyo asti sadrisho maya.
Yakshe dasyami modishya.
Yakshe dasyami modishya.
Ityatnana vimohitaha.
Ityatnana vimohitaha.
We'll stop here. So it keeps on going. The next few stanzas are only on the Asurika. Now this is the
entire chapter.
Yeah. Up to the, I think last 22nd or something is the word. He concludes by putting it into a stop. Somewhere.
Many more verses for Asurika.
Yeah. Up to 21.
Chapters for
them. 1 to 3rd, he describes all the good qualities. From 4th to 21st is Asurika. But you will understand 18 good qualities he explained, but all of us will understand that easily. Unless the Asurika is explained, you will not understand. Because Ahankaram, if you say, people will think, take it wrong. Therefore, he needs to explain what sort of Ahankaram is not good. That's why 18, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. 8 slokas for 18 qualities. But only 3 slokas for 18 qualities. And 22nd is how to avoid this, how to get into that. One single verse. Right? And what are the description things you have to do to be practical with this is the 23rd and 24th. I think 24 slokas only, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. With that, it will be over. Krishna.